So the next kind of programming language that is we are going to study is the C++ programming language. And this C++ programming language is just an implementation to the C language. So let us see a brief history of this, how the C++ programming language was introduced, how the C++ programming language was developed. So initially what happened is there was a language A. From this language A, we developed one more language which is called as a language B. Now from this language B, the incrementation version of language B was the language C. This language C was developed in 1970s by the scientist we know, that is, his name is Dennis Ritchie. Dennis Ritchie. Okay. Now, in case of this language C, so language C was having improvements over language B. They introduced a very new language which is having very new features. And these languages, most of these languages usually came into existence in 1960s to 1970s, because that was the time when they were developing the languages. Now, the main reason why the C language became famous was because it is very simple to understand and it is very, very powerful. Obviously, you know that the C language was a procedural programming language. It was not having object-oriented concepts. So initially, the C language was developed mainly for Unix operating system. To develop the Unix operating system, and later on this from this Unix operating system, different families of operating system developed. Some of the concepts of Unix operating system are, you know, they got this concept in Linux, which is an open source operating system. Some of the concept of Unix operating system is then implemented in Mac, as well as some of the concepts are also implemented in Windows as an operating system. Okay, so this C language was initially developed to create the operating system, which is a Unix operating system, and the kernel was actually written in C language. Why the kernel is written in C language? Because that kernel is acting as a mediocre between the operating system and the computer hardware. Okay, those kernels are actually communicating with the kernel hardware. So whenever you give some command, those commands are implemented in the kernel hardware, or they're implemented in the hardware. So C language was acting as an interface, and it is kind of a low-level programming language in that sense, because it is the one which is very, very, you know, it can communicate with the hardware, you can perform operations on the hardware with the help of C language. Now, in 1980s, what happened is, some people thought that we needed some more improvements in the C language. Okay. So later on when we started using the C language, some people thought that we needed more improvements in the C language. And what happened is, there are two branches which started from this. And this happened in 1980s, somewhere in 1980s, so 1979, 1980s. Now what they created is, they used, some people, they developed one more programming language, which is the C++ programming language. And this C++ programming language was developed by Bjarne Stråstrup. The name of the scientist was Bjarne Stråstrup. Okay, Bjarne Stråstrup. And the same way, at the same time, when Steve Jobs started his own next new company, that was called as the Next Computers. Now, this Next Computers took the C language and they developed some more features on the C language, and they created a language which is called as the Objective C. Now this Objective C language is just over the C language. They added more features to the C language, and with the help of this Objective C, later on they developed the very famous operating system which is called as the Macintosh operating system, or you can say Macintosh, or you can say Macintosh operating system, which is available in most of the computers. Most of the computers are working on Macintosh operating system. Okay, so they developed the Macintosh. Most of the computers, means most of the Apple devices actually, they developed using the Objective-C. And this Objective-C was having a lot of features of C language. It was very, very powerful. It is very, very fast, because it took the, you know, power of C language and it enhanced that power. And you can see natively it is supporting C language. Even your operating system kernel is supporting C language. So that is why most of the programs which are written in Objective-C, or most of the operating system which are written in Objective-C, they are very, very efficient, as well as they are very, very powerful. Okay, that we have seen in the past. You have seen how Macintosh is working, as well as even the iOS which you get in iPhones. this iOS is very, very efficient. If you give a very a lower level hardware in iOS and you try to implement it, then you can see that it is performing very well as compared to the Android level hardware. So iOS is developed in Objective-C, right? In the same way, in this Bjarne Stråstrup, he developed the C language, C++ language. Actually, he started it in 1979, somewhere in 1979, and there's a story behind this. And he he given this as a he implemented this with in 1980s, somewhere in 1980s it was publicly available. Okay, now what happened with Bjarne Stråstrup? He was actually doing PhD when he developed the C++ programming language. He's seen one more language which is Simula, and this Simula was having some object oriented features. Now he used this Simula language and he was studying the features of the Simula language, and then he thought that these kind of features should also be implemented with the C language, or there's some kind of programming language should be there which should implement these kind of object-oriented features. So what he did is he took the C language and later on he developed the C language to make it a C with classes, not C++. He developed C with classes. Now what was what is C with classes is he added some more libraries in the C language to make it a C with classes. And later on the name of the C with classes is changed to C++, because this plus is actually the same operator which we use like I++ or +i, post increment or pre increment. So this C++ is just a post increment operation, that is telling that everything, it is just an implementation version of C. So everything which is available in C language, that everything is also present in C++. But apart of that, there are a lot of new features they developed in C++ programming language. So also a lot of the programming libraries which they created for the C language, they preserved the features of C++ programming language. They preserved the features of C programming language. They preserved all the libraries, all the features which are available in the C programming language. And over that, they added more features to make it more powerful, to bring out a new version of C programming language. And this is how they introduced the C++ as the programming language. Okay, and this happened in 1980s. Now later on, this one more person who developed the Java programming language, and in 1990s they felt that this C++ programming language, there are some features which are wrongly implemented or which are unnecessary and which is making the language a bit complicated. And they tried to create one more language which is called as a Oak programming language, which is later named as Java. And this Oak programming language actually it is taking features of C++ programming language. They have not developed the Oak programming language over the C++, just like C++ is developed over C, but they have not developed the Java programming language over C++. Rather than they started or designing the Java programming language from the scratch, but they took features of C++ programming language to implement it in the Java. So in 1990s, they created this programming language which is Oak, or you can say Java. Now, this Java programming language was initially designed for hardware levels. For example, it was designed for levels like there's something called as like microwave ovens are there, washing machines are there. They developed this Java programming language to program the hardware, to program for the hardware. But later on, because it is very, very fast, Java was very, very fast. Its setup was very, very small, and Java was very, very fast. So, a small setup. So, people started using it. So, between 1990s to 2000s, Java became very, very famous. Okay. And a lot of new libraries, because they made the Java as open source. Somewhere in 1995 they made it open source. They visited so many countries, and there's a story behind that also. So they made it open source and people started adding a lot of libraries, people starting developing Java, and that is the main reason behind the success of Java. Okay, even Java was initially in Java, they were not having functions like taking input from the user, but later on they implemented this feature where they can take input from the user. Okay, and later on Microsoft thought we should also do something like this, and they developed the programming language which is .NET, and this .NET programming language just taken some features from Java programming language, but it was not open source. So they developed it, initially they developed it VB.NET, ASP.NET, etc., etc. And later on they developed this C#.NET, and the C#.NET was a better version of VB.NET, because VB.NET was having a lot of bugs, or you can say it was not very, very convenient. But nowadays, the most of the programming languages which are in use, they are Python for web development, Python and PHP. See, Python, in a few years back, around in 2007 to 2011, if you go to industry, the easiest way to find a job in the software companies was PHP, because PHP is a very easy to learn programming language, as well as a lot of websites was developed in PHP. But nowadays, because Python has evolved a lot in the last 4 years, Python became very hit. So Python has evolved a lot. In Python, they introduced a lot of things. That is why Python became very famous, and Python is actually faster than PHP in some sense. Okay, so now Python is in use in industries for web development purposes, and even for a lot of different purposes, obviously. Okay, so now our aim is to learn C++ programming language, and to learn C++ programming language, it is better that you have knowledge about the C programming language, because C++ programming language is just an implementation over the C programming languages. So there are a lot of features that that are available in the C programming language. They are also available in C++, but they also try to omit out some of the features which created some kind of confusion. Okay, so I hope this much introduction is more than enough. So let us start with this C++ programming language. And previously I've created those videos for the C language in 2014. I'm going to update those videos this year, as well as we are going to study the C++ programming language with this program. I'll try to teach you how and why I'm writing these things, how these things are working, as well as I'll try to see show you what is the output of the following programs, or what is the output you are going to get. Okay, so I think so let us start with the first C++ program about how to print, how to scan, or what are the various language fundamentals for the C++ programming language. So I'm not going to repeat a lot of concepts which we already discussed in C programming language, but this time what we will do is we'll try to execute some of the concepts which I already explained in C language, but we'll try to execute some of those concepts in C++, as well as I'll try to explain you some of those concepts again. Okay, so better is if you stay tuned to these videos, and this C++ programming language is very important for the students who are preparing for UGC NET examination, because in UGC NET examination they have C++ as a subject, and these are also very important for the students who are trying to build a career in as a software industry, because the C++ programming language, actually they are also using the C because it is very, very fast. So some of the complex applications, like we have trading applications, financial applications, because where the time is also a very key issue. So in big companies, they are still using C++ to develop some complex programs. Over the time, C++ has developed a lot. There are a lot of new libraries, there are a lot of new features, a lot of new data types they have introduced in the C++ programming language, and still you can say C++ is a modern language. It is not the case, like no one is using C language nowadays, or very few people or in very few companies are using C language, because they wanted to something to communicate with the hardware. But the C++ programming language, a lot of people are developing the C++ programming language, and it is still a big hit in the companies. Okay, so I think you should at least have a knowledge of C++ programming language, even if you want to study Java, or if you want to study something called .NET or any other this object-oriented programming language. And C++ is actually, it is creating basics for those kind of applications or those kind of subjects. Okay, or those kind of programs. Okay, because the concepts which are studied in C++ programming language, they are also used in those applications. Okay, so we'll start with a basic program, and we'll see how these programs are implemented and how we deal with them. Okay, so let us start with the next video.